Eric Bakker, thanks for coming back. We're going to talk about how you can test for enzyme deficiency. So a subscriber asked me, Eric, how do I test at home? How do I know I've got a deficiency of digestive enzymes? Because you keep talking about these digestive enzymes all the time. I hope this microphone's working. Oh, I got this huge, big blue microphone. Now I wonder if you can see, it's massive. It's huge. Right, so enzyme deficiency is very, very, very common. I see it so often in people. And I believe one of the key factors of enzyme deficiency is stress. Stress. People chewing too fast, eating the wrong kind of food, eating the wrong type of day, being glued to these flipping damn screens all the time when they're eating food. So many people now don't really chew properly. And they're engaged in social media when they're eating. It really irks me when I see that in restaurants or wherever I go. I see couples sitting there not even talking, just looking in these devices. Don't get me started. Anyway, easy to test. First thing you've got to do, I wrote a few points down here. Look for the deficiency symptoms first, okay? Bloating and gas. Feeling uncomfortable after eating. Eating a meal and then feeling, oh, I've got to loosen my waistband, or I just feel like I swallowed a brick, or feeling like a heavy feeling in the gut after you've eaten, okay? Abdominal cramping is a common one for some people, but bloating and gas are others. Also, irregular bowels or weird shaped bowel motions, okay? Food issues, so having problems with foods. So, oh, I can't eat that food. Every time I eat that food, I get some kind of rash or some problem or some reaction, or I don't like it, you know? So try and work out what particular type of food or food groups they are before you jump on the bandwagon and say, I can't eat gluten, it's making me sick and fat and ugly and all my hair's falling out. Okay, it might not be gluten, okay? So note, which foods are causing these issues? Have you worked it out yet? Try and do an elimination and challenge test on yourself. That's a great test. So you might have a suspicion about a particular food. Take that food out. Take it out for 3 or 4 days or even a week. Take that food back in, see what happens, okay? If you get again a feeling that it's reacting, take it out again, challenge the second time about a week later. If again, the second time you've had a reaction with it, it's time to start taking some enzymes to see if they can make the difference, all right? Now, the second point is you may not even need to do any of this because you may not even need to be chewing well in the first place, okay? I've said it before, people who chew well, poo well, okay? And remember the old saying, I've said this also before many times in the videos that I've made. Dr. Alan Gaby from America, one of the leading holistic physicians I know, big stools, small hospitals. Small stools, big hospitals, okay? So people who poop a lot tend to have a lot less problems with their health than people who don't poop that well or much at all right? So, and pooping is a good indication also of digestive enzymes. Look at the color of the stool, look at the texture of the stool, all of those nasty things that you don't want to talk about. Very important. You've got to see what comes out the tailpipe and make sure that it's okay, or you could have a problem. So, are you chewing okay? Chew. You really have to chew that food well. This is one of the key reasons I got my teeth fixed. It wasn't because I wanted to look like Rock Hudson or Brad Pitt or some guy like that. I already look like that anyway. I don't need to look any better than I look. But it was because I wanted to chew properly. I wanted the functionality back in my teeth again, okay? I have 3 teeth missing on this side and 2 teeth missing on that side. Being a baby boomer, I had a lot of molars drilled right out and even pulled out with just slight problems. They didn't fix teeth up back in my day. They just yanked them out. Different today. So if you've got poor teeth, this could be a reason why, again, you've got poor digestive function. If you can't chew properly, you also can't stimulate the body to produce enzymes, okay? The body is geared up to make enzymes, okay, by various nervous commands, but chewing, engaging the vagus nerve, will help to stimulate the production of enzymes too. So chew properly, okay? I've said it 1,000 times. So take enzymes with each meal. So this is an experiment I want you to do for a home test. You're chewing properly, you're eating the right kind of foods. We're not talking chicken nuggets and Dr. Pepper here, okay? We're talking like proper food, real food, all right? Food that you prepared at home, fresh, healthy food, because you can't really eat any kind of junk or crap or drink alcohol regularly if you're gonna take enzymes and test their functionality. alcohol must be out of the equation, because it will really affect the ability for the enzymes to work properly. So this is a 1 week challenge. No alcohol for 1 week. Can you do it? Yeah, I knew you couldn't do it. Of course you can do it. 1 week with no alcohol, it's not a problem. So you take the enzymes, just start taking one capsule with each meal, okay? Breakfast, lunch, and dinner. Observe the stool, observe the abdominal bloating, the cramping, all of those kind of signs and symptoms. Has it changed? Maybe you need to take a little bit more enzymes with a bigger meal, okay? Have a bit of an experiment maybe in the second week if you're game enough. If you find a marked reduction in gut issues with the enzymes, it's a clear indication you were deprived, you weren't having enough enzymes. So what we've done is we basically ripped out your spark plugs and we're trying to put new spark plugs in your engine to power it up. Because we all know the cars run a lot better with a tune-up, and digestive enzymes are a fantastic digestive tune-up for people, especially my age, 50s and 60s. But even for you young kids out there with these iPhones in your hand that seem to be super glued to your palm, they're good for you guys too, remember? Because you're not engaged. To me, eating and mobile phone is like texting and driving. There's no difference. You're just not engaged, you're not paying attention. Put that darn phone down, chuck it in the bin, then eat your food, all right? There's more important things than Facebook. Thanks for tuning in. Don't forget to click on the link below if you want my free report.